everyone! Welcome back to my favorites videos. Today's favorite is my July favorites, and if you're wondering why I'm wearing a hat, it's for two reasons. One is because this is one of my favorites, and two was because I wore it out earlier when I went to do my nails and now my hair is very flat. Anyway, speaking of nails, check out my new nail design. Very sweet and very nice, and the flowers are hand drawn. I'll blog about my nails soon. I'll link the post down below. Okay, so let me get started first. Since the head is already in frame, I'll just start by saying this is my one of my favorites for the month. It's this snapback from the Stage Walk. I recently shot for them, and Jamie let me pick out a few items that I like to keep, and this was one of the things that I kept, and I really like it. Actually, I really liked all of the clothes that I picked out, but they're in the washer, so I can't show it to you guys now, so maybe I'll feature them next month, or you'll see it in the blog post. But yeah, the hat is actually already sold out. Let me show you. But I think there are back orders for this, so you guys can get your hands on one if you like it, and it also comes in black. So I actually got some of my favorites into this bag here, so I'll just randomly pick up the stuff to share with you guys. So first up is my birthday present from my boyfriend. He got me this lilac purple shade long wallet from Kate Spade. And this is what it looks like inside. I have a lot of things. It's just like polka dots and blue. I really liked it, and I actually told him not to get me a wallet because he got me one last year for our anniversary, but he decided that I needed a new one and he bought me this, and it's very nice. I really like it, and it's very smooth leather. Yeah, he actually bought it while I was out running my errands, and he passed it to me. I didn't even know he bought this for me until he just grabbed my wallet and told me to change it to the new wallet. And yeah, thank you BB for this. Next up is what a lot of people have been asking me about, is the curling wand that I use. So here you guys can see, I'm actually not sure of the barrel size comparison with the hand, but yeah, this is from Rowenta for Elite Model Look. Elite Model Look, and this is the curling for all my curls in my pictures, unless they were done by my hair sponsor Shunji Matsuo. Otherwise, if they were done by me, they were done using this color. When I first bought it, I didn't really like it that much because I didn't know how to use it very well. But you know, recently I tried to be adventurous. I wanted to pick it up, and voila! I guess magic happened. Maybe I picked up something from watching Caely do my hair all the time. But yeah, this is the color. It's actually relatively cheap. I think it was below $40. I bought it at Watson's. Can't remember which outlet though. So yeah, if you guys are interested, maybe you can check it with Watson's. Maybe if I manage to find out how I can film with a mirror behind me, I will show you guys how I curl my hair. Okay, so let's see what I can get. First up is my ZA lipstick. I actually got this a while ago. This is the Pure Shine Lips in Lady Rate 06. Like I said, I got this a while ago, and you know, I really liked them when I got them, but for some reason I don't know why I stopped using them. I'm actually using them now, and because the color is pretty sheer, it's rather beautiful, probably to medium. So I really like to use this for the Korean Ojang Gradient lip look. I'll link the video somewhere, maybe here, and you guys can check that out if you like. I'm wearing it today. I really like the color. It's very flattering, and because it's red with like bluish undertones, it makes your teeth look whiter. That's a tip. So next is the MAC Pro Longwear SPF 10 Foundation. I'm in NC20. My sister actually gave this to me because I don't know why my skin tone actually lightened, probably from using DRX products. I went for a facial recently as well, and yeah, my skin tone lightened and my own foundation didn't fit me. I asked her for one, she passed me this, and I've been loving it. I've been wearing this for my photo shoots and everything. And it really does last long. The coverage is pretty decent and it didn't break me out. So if that's a good gauge, you guys might want to check this out. Next up, mascara. This is the kit Lash Extensions Mascara, if I'm not wrong. I'm actually wearing it today. My lashes are actually pretty short. And they actually have like fibers. I'm not sure if you guys can see it. Lengthening fibers. And this is really a good lengthening mascara. It's not very good for volume though. But for volume, I have something else that I prefer this month. And it's this VDL's Eye Bomb. I mean, it's really as the name suggests, Eye Bomb. I'm not sure if I've featured this, but I've been loving this as well for volume mascara. And it really loads up on a lot of volume. But the formula's a little wet, so I like to dab off the excess products onto a tissue first before I apply it onto my... I wanted to say face. Okay, before I apply it onto my eyelashes so that it doesn't print onto my lids. Next up is the K Palette Lasting 2-Way Brow. I was also sent this quite a while ago and the I didn't get to use this because when I was sent this, this was too dark for my hair color. Now that my hair color is of a darker shade, this really suits my hair skin tone hair color. So it comes with a brush at one end. It's like this. It's very lightly pigmented, so you can build it up. And on the other side, you get a sponge tip for you to blend. So basically what you do is you define the shape at the ends. And then after that, you go to the sponge powder and blend the front so that it gives a more natural look. I really like this now that I got to use it and it really matches my hair color. So yeah, do check it out. It comes in other colors as well. Completely random, but I put this in the box because my new name cards are here. They actually arrived early. I was supposed to get them like today, which is the end of the month, but I actually got them early. So this is what my name card looks like, and with my links at the back. And I designed it myself and I'm really really liking this. So I am very excited to start giving this out to people because my old name cards had all the wrong links. I wouldn't say wrong, but it's all my old links and they don't work anymore, so I can't give them out anywhere. I'm using them as like mascara guts now. So next up is Kate's Brightening Makeup Base for Cover. I'm wearing this today and I really like that it brightens. The other day I wore it for my photo shoot and Jamie commented, she was like, "Do you use a primer today? Your face looks more glowy," and it was the day that I used this. And I really like it because it doesn't feel oily and it doesn't break me out. So do give this a try. I do however use this like I would a highlighter. I don't apply all over my face. I do my normal HD primer before applying this onto the high points like the T-zone, the cheeks, and a little on my chin. So maybe if you guys would like to try out this way, you could, but you can most definitely apply it all over your face. And one more product from VDL I'm really loving is the Festive Mineral Blusher Love Mark in... I forgot the shade. I will write it down below, but it's just this beigey orange color. It's shimmery and it's a mineral duo. And it just looks very pretty. I'm wearing it today and it really highlights your cheekbones and give it very nice and natural color. Am I getting to the end? Okay, nearly the end. And also from VDL is one of their Love Mark W Sweet Room. My favorite color is not this duo, but actually this pink shade here. I like using it to highlight under my eyes these days. I'm wearing it today and I really really like it. It's also a mineral duo. It's almost chrome. It's like pink with gold glitter and it's very very pretty. Also, I used it on like my lid just right in the center and it brings a lot more dimension as opposed to if you were to leave your lids bare. just a couple more products. Eyeliners. Okay, so my Kate Gel eyeliner. This is, if I'm not wrong, it's the matte one, BK1. I got this from an event as well, so as did the other Kate and VDL products. And I really like the formula of the gel liner because it is very creamy, very matte, and it dries very quickly. Really, really, really like this. If you're trying to look for a starter gel liner, you can give this a try. I believe it is very, very affordable. And last is the VDL Ready Action Pen Liner Sponge Action. So what I really like about this is, for a sponge liner, it is really, really black. And you can draw very thin lines on this. And what I really like about it is, once it dries, it does not smudge. Let me wait for it to dry. See, it doesn't smudge. It's not going anywhere. The last favorite actually is my new watch. This was kindly sponsored by Aries Gold, and it's just this ceramic watch with sapphire crystal and Swarovski elements. And it's very, very, very pretty. It comes with a 10-year warranty. I was sponsored this by Aries Gold, and they're actually sponsoring me another watch for a giveaway. And you guys get to choose which watch you like out of 6 designs that they have offered for you guys. And the giveaway isn't actually open yet. I will link it down below when it is, and I'll let you guys know about the giveaway mechanics in the down bar as well when it opens. So that's about it for my July favorites. I hope that you guys like this video, and if you do, please give this a thumbs up and subscribe, and I'll see you guys soon. Bye!